God will leave here in less than a few minutes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Psalm 3 verse 3, which is our theme for this month. Our divine upliftment. Hallelujah. He said, oh Lord, thou art a shield and the lifter up of my head. Whatever that makes your head to bow down is not part of God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The first, I want you to take this prayer point very serious, because we are just at the period of just, we have just less than 6 weeks to cross for the next year. Just 6 weeks to the next year. I don't know what is making your head to bow down. I don't know what is making your family's head to bow down. But you have a God and the lifter up of your head. You pray this prayer as I take them out for us. I will pray. Pray with fervency. Hallelujah. Pray with God fervency. A man, chapter 11, verse 17. The Bible says, and Jesus said to them that my house shall not be the house of God, but the house of God. Prayers. In Isaiah chapter 56, verse 7. He said what he said, in my heart they shall make burnt offerings with God. Prayer. Hallelujah. Let's go around it. You know Saturday in the spirit that we are in. Let's start. Amen. We'll pray. Amen.
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 The first thing happened is you said, oh Lord, the lifter up on my head. Whatever that makes my head to bow down, whatever that makes the head of my loved one and my family to bow down, Father, overturn me today for my good. In the mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth and fire prayer. Say, oh Lord, thou art the lifter up on my head. Whatever that makes my head to bow down, whatever that makes my head to bow down, thou art the lifter up on my head. Whatever that makes my head to bow down, whatever that makes my head to bow down. Now, once you discourage me, I
man? Is it because he lacks integrity? Is it because of his sin? I don't know why people are talking you over. Some say your integrity is normal. Some say it's because of your sin. That's why you're having this challenge. But you will play the prayer. You say, oh Lord, in this month of December, Father, any bad news that will make me to cry, any bad news, whether from my loved one or from my home, from the village, from here, that will make me to weep and shed tears, Father, this evening, this morning, as I pray, oh Lord, turn it from my own good and turn it as a good news. Lift up your voice and pray. Every bad news, oh Lord.
Every form of sickness, every form of death that is circumvented around.
that you found like that like Baba Jide talk. Every form of reproach, every form of shame, every form of backwardness, every form of comment that we face.
Transgenerational people. Have you come to the point?
proud and the white ones. But he's saying that maintain your dedication to God, your commitment to God, and your service to God. And at the very point of the end, you will overturn and give up double for every of our trouble in the mighty name of Jesus. So when they doubt your faith, don't worry. Trust God. As far as you know that your hands are clean, and as far as you know that you're living a life of purity, maintain, serve God very clean. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
People might not like you now because you love God too much. They are fanatic, they are not just a fan, they are fanatic of God. Don't worry. The same people that are doubting your integrity, they will be part of the group to be your celebrity.
Amen.
I'm telling you the rest of you. Now, today, some people are going in Nigeria and say, send me money. And God has shared the next money. He said one time, about that brother that is serving you for money now. Don't think he is fond like the rest of you. I tell you, you will end the same way your elder brother ended. But today, the reverse is the case. Amen. I pray God will give us understanding about the name of Jesus. The fourth thing is that the fourth thing that temptation brings to us to make us to doubt our dedication to God and run away from it is temptation aims to organize situations that put us under pressure to relax our confidence in God or even seek for alternatives, which is very dangerous. Job 2 verse 9, just as the Lord said, curse this God and die. Do you want to die in this way? Fifth thing is a temptation or the nice situation when God seems to be silent. Papa, he had no idea what he said when God is silent. Please, let me get it. Whenever you are asking God for something, like me, there is one pattern I've been asking God for. I've never had God answer either by what God is or by reading the word. Dina. When God is silent, you need to be careful about that. Because he's silent might mean that he's doing a lot of work that God wants. But when you move ahead of God, then God will come still. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What do you do in situations of temptation to maintain your temptation? One, never surrender your conviction to your conditions. No matter how the temptations come, never you. You know, one thing with us as it is that we are so weak because of this God that was in us. We are so weak to surrender our conviction. What you know that this is the truth, this one, you don't need them to even tell you that it's truth. But we are easily just ourselves because of certain condition. Those of us are went to yes, you will see a lot of people asking you, why don't you smoke because you still have to come and ask you what is wrong with you? Maybe there's someone here, maybe there, yeah, you went and spoke, but God delivered you in the mighty name of Jesus. Or maybe, no, it's temptation of life. I shout my brother one, I said, sometimes, no matter how this our character we got, in your closest place, when you go, there are certain temptations that will come to you, you may not like something else. But when you hold on to God, so it happens to everybody. Hallelujah. Or if you travel to Nigeria, maybe there are some persons you've met before, you know, like the brothers, some sisters you've met before, and they're waiting for you. And you come, I'm coming. Hallelujah. Amen. So never surrender. Let your condition become the thing that your condition will bow to, not your condition bow to your condition. Let the faith you have in God conquer the situation at the moment. And God will say, that is my son, that is my brother, that is my leader. The second thing we have to do in terms of that is, in the middle of contradictions and confusion, never leave the grips of God. That is one dangerous thing. No matter how the people force accusation on you, no matter how they point fingers to you, don't leave the presence of God. Because when you leave the presence of God, you are exposing yourself more to the dark world. In the discovery channel, heart of the animals, the big animal and the best thing with the smaller one. They trace the animal, until they separate the animal from the clone or from the colony. And when that one is separate, they can easily divorce. Because they know in that colony, they cannot, no matter how big it might be. So the devil wants to take us away from God, so that he can have access to us. May God bless us in the mighty name of Jesus. Trust God even when you cannot trace God. Very important. I know it's hard. Trust God even when you cannot trust God, because sometimes He will seem so silent. But if you can trust Him, then you will be able to implement His relationship service. Keep doing those things you are doing for God. In fact, in terms of temptation and tribulation, that is when you are to do more. To make the devil to be ashamed. For example, someone is accusing you innocently, and the person keeps seeing you praying, serving God, doing your work, attending your classes, doing what you're supposed to do. The person will even get so tired. Oh, what are you doing to this girl? She's still serving God. What is her secret? But when it comes, remember, it's the question. Dedication is key to the power of repentance. The third thing to this, never surrender your destiny to comments and complaints of people, especially the ungodly. Never you surrender your destiny to the hand of the company and comments of the ungodly or the godly. And what he says something? He said, never you allow compliments to get into your heart so strong, and never you allow commendation, any negative commendation to sink upon you. Because if you allow compliments so much, you might lose focus. And if you allow the thoughts of the negative ones to set in your heart, you become an enemy to your own self. The last I'll say is keep your faith alive by connecting to the right words of God and the right company. Job 40:40 said, until my appointed time I will wait. Keep your faith alive. Let's put you on our feet. Say, keep your faith alive. And remember that there is a future beyond every temptation. And the drastic intervention of God to solve temptations makes us to become everything that we do. So let's close our eyes. I don't know why you made this model. But in this 11th month, God is still waiting. I'm just waiting for just a soul that will say, here I am. I dedicate myself affection to you. I know because of challenges of life, I must have made some mistakes. I must have spoken some ill words. Because of false accusations that arose against me. Because of what people said against me. Because of how people doubted my identity and my faith in you. Lord, I must have gone astray. Because of the distractions of this world today and the fluctuations of destinies, the choice to make, we have to go, next phase of life, troubles of the world. I must have done for you. But here I am. If there's one empty vessel you need to use, Lord, use me. Lift up your hands to heaven as we pray. I say, God, help me. Help me. Help me. If you're here and you want to make another U-turn, I will not call you back. Maybe I don't have the power to call you back. But within yourself, I want you to pray this simple prayer and say, Lord, draw me closer to you. The song that our sister wrote this morning, he said, draw me closer to you. Let me feel the warmth of your embrace. How far have you kept the warmth of God's embrace? Lord, I'm coming back to you.